champion and your referee. You look at the records of these guys, it indicates that there's power to be seen here tonight. A lot of knockouts on both sides of the ledger, and both tall, wiry guys. To me, that usually means you get leverage in your punches, and yes, indeed, you can have power.
Soto's kind of giving that look there. Red corner, like he's going to charge out. Let's see if we get some early action here between these two heavy-handed fighters. Two good-looking welterweights. See who can emerge. Hernandez unbeaten at 16-1. Soto 11-1-1. Soto wearing the green with gold trim. Freddy Hernandez in blue with white. Freddy Hernandez heard a lot about his father earlier. His parents were divorced early on in his life. He's close to his dad. His father is Riel Hernandez. He was a fighter. But he never really pushed his son in that direction. In fact, a teacher at school told Freddy that boxing is a nice way to defend your girlfriend. And that's when things clicked with Hernandez. He said he was always curious. He always heard about his dad. So upon the teacher's advice, he went to the gym.
This looks like a nice matchup. On paper here. And I'm interested to see if it translates into a nice fight. Sometimes a good even matchup is a chess match. We'll find out. But on paper, nice matchup by Don Jargon. Because the world is full of magic. After the Oya Golden Boy poses along with Eric Gomez. Don Jargon says it's going to be a tremendous matchmaker in the years to come.
Well, if the Hall of Famer Don Jargon puts his stamp on approval for the young man in the boxing business, you can bet he's going to be on target.
The Hall of Fame Don Jargon. Exactly.
Hernandez works behind that jab. He's fired in a few straight right hands. Sun has set. Here's the Playboy Mansion. Lights are on.
The only loss, as I said earlier, for Soto, who an undefeated two-time Olympian, an undefeated Olympian who Soto took the fight on short notice.
On Nurhan Suleiman back in January of this past year. You know, he may have gotten overconfident in training then because he was sparring with the great Antonio Margarito, who's a very well-skilled championship-level elite welterweight.
And in sparring with him, he was having some success against Margarito, and he said to himself, you know what, I think I can take this fight against Suleiman, even if it sounds short. If you know it's far apart from somebody else, it sounds great that you're in there with a great guy, world champion, a tremendous caliber fighter. And you say that's going to give you an advantage, but sometimes it gives you a disadvantage because you're at their back and forth. You're going around, they tell you, it's their camp, not your camp. So yeah, you're in there with a great guy, but you might not be getting all the rounds you want to get. The champion is getting around. After all, he hides it.
You're hearing some unique noises in the background here of this fight because we are just a few feet away from Hugh Hefner's private garden zoo, and some of our fine other friends are taking in the bite and enjoying it themselves. Good action here.
We're getting a
split
plug, sir.
Best of Baseball Tonight web jam.
Take the Miller Chase Cubs today. Football.
Wednesday night at 8 Eastern, the Baseball Tonight staff is going to hand out their mid-season awards and give you a preview of the second half of the baseball season. It's the Best of Baseball Tonight web jam mid-season awards special. That is Wednesday night at 8 on ESPN. Tell you about some of the sounds coming from in back of the ring here. Here's a look at the zoo in Hef's backyard. Playboy Mansion, a little bit of everything.
I'm glad you explained that, Joe, because I wasn't sure what those sounds were.
Round number two between Soto and Hernandez, scheduled for 10. Talk about that fight. It's first that he lost Soto when he took on Nurhan Suleiman and punches in round one more even. He said, you know, I don't have any regrets about doing that. It was a learning experience. We'll see what he can take from that and develop it in this fight against Hernandez.
Both tall guys, both would like to use their height for an advantage. Set a line in that canvas. Catch the guy before he crosses it. Hold him at that line. Let the other guy help him a little bit. He walks in to his range.
but they both have those advantages. Both have those disadvantages.
Looking into a mirror.
Teddy, earlier, speaking of awards, talking about baseball tonight, giving out their awards later this week, the ESPY Awards. And we were visiting with Antonio Tarver, great world champion in boxing superstar. You know, Antonio Tarver is up for a push player of the year in the ESPY, but he's also up for upset of the year in all sports with his knockout of Roy Jones.
That's what happens when you knock out a guy that everybody thinks is invincible, Roy Jones Jr. at the time. As I was saying with this fight, both guys have physical similarities. Height. They both like to use that height, but it's going to come down to who's going to find a way to be aggressive. And right now, Ken is trying to do that. Whoever can find a way to be aggressive within the realms of safety and responsibility, he's going to have an edge. And right now, I think that is the task in both fighters' minds. You wonder who's the bigger puncher. If you look at common opponents, and we have a common opponent, Oscar Delgado, both fighters for him. If you look at that result, maybe Soto is the bigger puncher. If you go by the results of that, Soto knocked out Oscar Delgado while Hernandez won a decision.
Soto was obviously able to take him out. He did so in the seventh round by knockout. Hernandez went six rounds against Delgado.
They say that this kind of matchup, and I would find it's a good even matchup if you get a chest back. So far, the little chest, the moves they're trying to make is to find out who can get to the other guy's king, who can get past the court, and for three in other words, who can find a way to be aggressive. Without walking into that power, they each respect, each possession.
Hernandez turns and points the right hand. Scheduled for 10 rounds. And around number 6, we were watching the Tuesday night fight. Next time at the Playboy Mansion, the start of round number 3 between Jesus Soto and Freddy Hernandez. Soto in the green, Hernandez in blue with white trim. Hernandez was 20 out of 59 in total punches connected in that second round.
There is intrigue in this fight. They both know how to fight. One undefeated, one with one loss. Both have power. I want to see how they figure out the plan to get that power to each other's chin.
In the opening moments here of the third round, maybe a slight cut has started near the right eye of Freddy Hernandez. The longer that.
Right hook about earlier, Joe, last round. There is some bleeding in the corner of the right eye. He's dead. Coming down, but it's coming down outside the eye, so not as tearing the roof. Right now, Hernandez has to be more aggressive. Lazar is looking to box a little bit, looking to let Soto help him a little bit, take what he gives him. Big spots where Soto misses. Both these fighters have been changing from backing up to pushing forward, forcibly. I was just mentioning in the last round that whoever can find a way to go, they're going to try to take it. Control the fight. So far, what each has done that is fine. They have controlled that part of the round. But it can also be giving control to the other guy. If they're aggressive in any kind of bad way, it can open the door for the opponent, the other guy, to counter. And all of a sudden, the bank turns this fight around. The need for attention to be paid for both fighters have power.
An angle to the 35-year-old and Soto came in lunging with a looping right hand.
I like what I see with Hernandez. He's a little bit more dimension so far than Soto. Right? And he can also have the instinct to step back, look like that, and look for counter opportunities too. Looks like he has two sizes of two options. That's always better than one. Jamie Little is standing by. Jamie?
That's right, I'm with LeVar Arrington, and you're having a good time out here. I saw you throwing a little right hand. I got to ask you, though, Joe Gibbs, back coach, what do you think about that?
I'm excited. I mean, to have a man of his caliber come out of retirement to rescue a team in need, you know, I'm really excited about it. He's really proven what type of coach and what type of person he is just over the mini-camp, just over the off-season, so... I'm really excited about the upcoming season.
Obviously a true leader. He's won NASCAR championships. He's won Super Bowls. And now he's back with you guys. He obviously missed football a little bit, huh?
He must have. Like I said, you know, Shorty sat at home on Sundays watching us play. And, you know, we didn't give him too much to be too happy about, unfortunately. But, you know, I think he feels he can come back and help him. And the team, as players, we believe he can do it as well. So I think it's going to be a little different this year.
All right, LeVar. Best of luck to you guys. Let's get back to boxing, guys.
LeVar Arrington. So why did ESPN work for LeVar Arrington this offseason? Other judges on Dream Job. We'll see at the end of this fight if we could have used his judging skills. This fight between Soto and Hernandez. Petty that. Cut above the right eye of Hernandez that his opponent has tended to. We got word that was caused by a flash accidental foul that caused that cut. Of course, California rules, we have to go to score first after the fourth round has started for a technical decision, so we have achieved that this fight.
Where are the edges? Knight thinks maybe Hernandez can capitalize on it. Soto has to pay attention on his size towards his feet. Soto has power. But what are the advantages? Soto, when he goes defensive, he doesn't usually go back to those one thing. In the offensive, he looks offensive. Knight can be a big edge to Hernandez. He knows when he's thrown at him, he can really bring it. He knows when the ball is thrown at him, he has to pay attention to counties and defense.
So in the green trunk, Hernandez is really telling you talking
about. This is especially concerning the fact that Hernandez admitted to us that he wants to work on his defense. So he wants to work on his defense. Well, if the guy's turning it on and turning it off, it gives him the opportunity to win. So he's going to lose. He can't concentrate on it. That's a good point. Because there's a window. Let you go when you can and when you can. And that's very important in that square circle. When you can play, when you can. See, right there, Hernandez doing his part. Soto went into that defensive position. Hernandez knew that he probably had a 2-3-second window to get shots off without anything coming back again. When Soto goes defensive, to good sword. He's not thinking about it. And you know what? Hernandez knew it. But Soto is being taken advantage now by those flaws that Hernandez, I believe, noticed.
Hernandez letting his hands go here in the last minute of this fourth round. Some good work behind the jab. Throwing some solid straight right hands here in round number four. In the aggressor. Soto comes into the body shot from the left hand.
He says whoever finds a way, Joe, to be aggressive can at the edge. Hernandez has found that way while Soto has gone defensive.
This just in a nationwide